That is Bhagavad Gita. For this Gita given by Bhagavan Sri Krishna will have solution for each of every one of your problem. Now, I'm talking about Bhagavan Buddha. Bhagavan Buddha said that this world is full of miseries. Why miseries we have? Because the cause of miseries is desires of human beings. He not only said that, he has given a solution for it. What is that solution? That is Ashtanga Marga. If you adopt Ashtanga Marga, you will be the most self-satisfied person in the world. Samyak Drushti, Samyak Kriya, Samyak Vak, Samyak Jnana, and so on. Adopt Ashtanga Marga. This is the best value system. And coming, I'm now going to talk about the great king of India. He is none other than the great Ashoka. I think he is the most, is the only king in the world who preaches the morality values among the people of his country, his kingdom. If you go through the rock edicts of Ashoka, you will come across a term called Dharma, Dhamma. It's a Pali language, Dhamma. Where he told about the how to remain the harmony among the people, how you should be with your neighbors, parents, gurus, and friends, everybody, how to treat the human beings. Don't forget the friends, the yoga and meditation, which are given by the great rishis of India. This is a great gift we got. Adopt these values and come out from the your problems and become a very good citizen of your country. Thank you.
Very nice, Naveen Kumar, for reminding us of our scriptures, Upanishads, Bhagavad Gita, Buddha, Ashoka, and the examples given, how these values can solve our today's problems so that we can rise from an ordinary citizen into a good citizen. There is other side of the coin, which is the which are the modern values. So let us listen to Shivaji Shankar from Proddaturu, Kadapa.
Pranam Swamiji and my dear young and dynamic brothers and sisters of India, my heartfelt pranams to all of you. I'm here with a great saying to share my views. Old is gold, that all of you know it. But keeping the gold, keep on hold, we can't get anything else. Gold is old, but we keep it in our hold, we get nothing we get from the gold. The gold is like a Vedanta, but ancient values. Just with the ancient values, we are unable to understand and digest them. That is why the modernity means what? New, current generation, present, a contemporary, the present situations, whatever we have today, just moderated. The present generation has an ability to mold the men and women of our country, to mold the nation with a great inspiration, with his creation. They're molding us, just moderating the ideas. And we can say like that, we are all in the present generation is a modern generation, isn't it? Yes or no? So in the modern generation, we have to behave like a modernity only. But all modern qualities or values are imbibed or gathered from the ancient values only. But we just moderate according to our situation. We have seasons. According to seasons, we just mold ourselves. The animals mold ourselves. Like that, we have to mold. We should not go back. One of the great purposes like this. The values means which brings us ahead. The values means which brings us ahead, not to brings us back. We should not go back again. But these all our ancient values are moderated to present generations. So with that moderate values, we have to go ahead and you can say that like advanced. Advanced means what? Which is ahead. We are in ahead position. We should not go ahead towards backwards. We are already in advanced position. Like for example, we can say that we have a mobile, like old in 20 years ago or 10 years ago. We are not using that. Why? It doesn't have a lot of features. Now, we have on-road facilities. Like that modern ideas are which are applicable for our generation. The modernity is which we have the creation of our nation. That is what my emotion that I got from the words Swami Vivekananda's inspiration. And we can tell you that the all authority, we can't go back immediately or something slowly go back. Do you like to go back? How many of you are ready to go back? No. By being here only, you're ready to go back. It means that you don't want something to go ahead. You won't want to see your country, our country, to see in front of us. Still, when we are born, we heard that India is developing country. Still, it is India is developing country. Why? We didn't understand. We didn't digest the value of ancient values. That is where there is a matter moderated. Even that inscriptions, Swami Vivekananda only says that. I have the faith and hope on the younger generation. Why? The younger generation have that kind of ability to mold our nation. Isn't it? Why he has that kind of a faith on us? We are updated. We are advanced. We can know the present situations, whatever the problems we have. The old people can do that. You can see in something like a faculty, the old faculties, they have a generation gap. Isn't it? The generation gap makes us not to understand perfectly. So we have that kind of a nature to understand what is going on in our society. We have all the technologies and with the science and everything. Otherwise, we are unable to. I say that ancient values we have to follow, but those the things only moderated in modernity. Modernity is what? Something with a advanced or a current generation. That is what I would like to share, and that's all. That I can conclude that modern generation is a good for us. Thank you.
Shivashankar, congratulations and thank you for putting your thoughts forward. What exactly is the values or what we have to do in the modern life? Don't look back, but try to go forward. You have pointed out India is in a advanced position with all the technologies and science, etc. So some more points we'll listen, then understand what you are trying to say and what the friends on the other side of ancient values have to say. So now at present we are all listening to these two teams, ancient values representatives and modern values representatives, and try to say what are the modern values. Those who are speaking on the other side, modern values, please mention one or two modern values which you think are better than ancient values. Okay, that will make things clear. As earlier friend Naveen said about India being the spiritual guru, the Upanishadic values, Kathopanishad, Shraddha, Ramayana, Rama's personality, or India's women values, Sita, Savitri, Damayanti, like that, try to put forward what you think are the modern values, which will carry more weight to your subject. May I request now Ms. Shabari Kumari from Bangalore National Degree College to present her thoughts.
Pranam to all the Swamiji's present here and Mataji's and my brothers and sisters who have come along to youth convention. Swamiji says, we will find there is no value expecting experience which teaches something. Now how will we learn and how do we experience it? Family is the place we get the experience. Parents and our old age grandparents come here and teach us the experiences. In the ancient period, grandparents used to be with the grandparents. They were around 20 to 30 people, and they come during the night times and tell the stories. They used to tell about our Indian culture, our patriotism. By this, children were aware of what they used to be like, how to be in the present situation. In the ancient period, people used to give importance to the people and their emotions, which was very important in those days. In this generation, people are giving importance to the money and forgetting the emotions. You can see so many old age homes being established almost in every cities and in the villages also nowadays. They're forgetting the parents who cared us a lot, and they're putting them to the old age home because they don't have time to spend with their parents. They feel they're heavy to take care of them. And I feel that children are missing the care of the parents and grandparents because of the nuclear family. Swamiji saying that in ancients, those whose bodies get destroyed in the service of others and the society. In modern days, bodies is destroyed by the enjoyment and the selfish life. They alone live who live for others, said Swamiji. I would like to conclude by this. Thank you.
Very good, brief and short. Now may I request the representative from Modern Values, Ms. Sahana S. Desai from Davangere, Karnataka.
Nobody is born in this world because he or she wanted it. For the reason of being born, one should live and let others live in harmony. Good afternoon, Young India. My puja pranam to all the Swamijis, and warm and pleasant good afternoon to all my dear friends. It's my pleasure to talk about the topic to be a good citizen, which is more important, ancient values or modern values. It's modern values according to my friends. Firstly, I would like to say you what modern values actually mean. Actually, dear friends, modern values are the quality of mind and activity that gives very essence for a person to understand the future by appreciating the values of past and understanding the sentiments of present. Friends, fossilized thinking is foreign to such modern persons. In this sense, all the great men of mankind have been and still are modern. At the psychological level, the youths who are the citizens always search noble ideas. Here, friends, old ideas are questioned mercilessly and given the go-by unceremoniously. Now, I would wish to say some things about the characteristics of modern youth with modern values. From the physical viewpoint, youth is the best period of life, a period with health, strength, and energy. Endowed with strength and brimming with energy, the young people are apt to feel courage, great courage. The citizens who take up modern values are fired with the spirit of adventure. They can plunge themselves into the act of daredevilry. High ambitions come to them naturally. Goaded with modern values, citizens can work hard and undergo any amount of suffering in their way of success. Defeats cannot easily send them into dejection, since optimism is in their very blood. Friends, I hope you all heard about the book on Swami Vivekananda Ji, The Gift Unopened. It's a very great book. Friends, in the present age, if we go with ancient values without recognizing the modern values, these modern values become the gift unopened, isn't it? This morning, Swami Atma Shraddhananda Maharaj Ji gave an example. I would like to recall it. Friends, when you go to meet your friend, you carry some fresh fruits, fresh, delicious fruits as a token of love to your friend. Will you carry rotten and old fruits? So, likewise, how can we conclude that ancient values are important? We should go ahead, friends. We should go ahead with fresh fruits, not rotten fruits. By including modern values in the present age, two positive results can be gained. The youth can easily start gaining to support themselves and their family. The pressure on the universities, there's a lot of pressure on universities nowadays, friends, in the present age. That pressure can be considerably eased so that the higher education and research of top quality can be done. I would like to convince you with one more example, friends. When the pain appears in the wrist and it is cured by medicine, it will reappear in the knee joint or in the shoulder. It changes its place, but it never ends unless a correct medicine which can cure it can be done. So friends, in the present age, there are problems to youth. To solve those problems, I think modern values are needed. One of my worthy opponents said, woman was given more freedom in the ancient time. But friends, I hope you all know about the Sati system. Hope you know Sati system. How mean it is, friends. If her husband dies, why should she have a life? By this we can understand, ancient values didn't give freedom to a woman. It always stick her into a dark corner of kitchen. That's all. Friends, modern values are characters that should be inculcated first and foremost. Finally, by saying, to become a good citizen in present age, modern values are successive path for advice, guidance, consultation and change of views, which should result in positive action plans. Swami Vivekananda Ji says, my faith is in younger generation, the modern generation. Out of them will come my workers. Thank you. Sarve jana sukhina bhavantu.
So Ms. Sahana, thank you for your fiery presentation and trying to conquer the minds of the people who are sticking on to ancient values, making them come out of the box and think of the modern problems. Illi charche nadithiruvaga alleno charche nadita ide. Here something is going on, there bus is going on. That is not right. Adi ancient illa modern illa nidre. So please cooperate, support sabha maryadeni rakshisbeku. Meerantha chaala manchollu. So don't try to give negative vibrations. Okay. Vivekananda wants active participation, not gossip. Swami Ranganathanji was there, a great personality of our order, used to tell, India is not getting one gold medal properly, but if there is a world gossiping championship, all the medals for the youth of India. So don't gossip there. Put your attention here. Very important topic. You have come to participate. So please participate nicely, listen, appreciate, and try to think over this subject. So now, after listening to Sahana, lot of points she has put forth, worthy of discussion, worthy of thinking. Let us see how the entire process goes on. Still two more speakers are there for us to interact. May I request now Mr. Akash Singh from Hyderabad Vivekananda College to share his thoughts on ancient values.
If what we have in the present generation is the result of action of what we had in the past, what we are going to have in future is going to be a result of action of what we do now. My hearty pranam to all the Swamijis and a very good afternoon to all the delegates present here. I'm strongly in support of ancient values. What is India today is because we had a very rich cultural and ancient civilization. Earlier in the education system, there was a relationship between the Swami and the Guru and the Shishya, where the value-based education was the main core subject for the studies. Nowadays, science and arts have taken over this kind of value-based education. People are more into studying science, arts. There's no value education class. I want to put forward a question before all of you. How many of you attended value education classes in your school? Or how many of you really had value education classes in your school? I don't think we are promoting much of value education nowadays, which is the most core important subject. We may be very ahead in science and technology, like my friend Shiva Shankar put forward that India is going very much in science and technology. But what is the use of that science and technology if we are not using it in the right direction? We may develop the nuclear power, but we need to use that nuclear power in resources in areas which can help in the development of our country, and not in bombarding nations, and not in any other activities. In modern times, the youth is attracted to following most of the cultures of the Western civilization. There are very good points from the West you can take,